What's up, party people? Greetings and salutations from the Incognito House. This here, this is the lovely Lady B.
It is.
My name is Ichabod Bones, aka the Incognito Mouse, but you can call me Icky. These lovely Oregon trees, bunch of these wood branches down along this path we took this walk a couple weeks ago. We're dubbing this possibly El Quarantino 3.0. Bunch of wood over here. Weeks ago, what, maybe two and a half weeks ago or so, there was a really bad ice storm here in Oregon. Really bad, like the worst they've had in several years. And the trees, it wasn't really snow, just ice, and it iced for a long time. The trees got full of ice and lots of trees fell down, lots of power lines fell down, and there was catastrophic power loss here for quite a long time. Yeah. A lot of people were without power for 3 or 4 days. We were without power for over 10 days, 11 and a half, 12 days without power. And there are still people now that are still without power, coming up on, I don't know, 15, 20 days. Still without power. It was bad. So we're still recovering from that. Take a little walk, show some of the damage that's out here and how we are recovering. This is a path that we took before. Some ducks over there, and there's just a bunch of, you know, trees here that have been snapped all over there. There's this little water here that we walked along. Slough. Sayu. It looks like they tagged this one off with a pink tag. So we were without power for over 10 days. We lost power, I think, on a Saturday, right?
Yeah.
In the afternoon. So that night I was actually at work, and that night I went home, and we have a fireplace. So we just kind of roughed it with the fireplace. It was cold. It was like 30 some degrees and it was bad. We were freezing that night. And I think we stayed one more night, and we sent the kids away to another place where they have power, so they didn't have to deal with it. We were too cold. We went to a hotel for a couple nights, and the expenses were way high because they were gouging the prices, because everyone needed electricity. Like, there were a lot of people who were traveling on the interstate. Interstate 5 comes right through here, I-5. A lot of people were stuck on the interstate with no power and no gas, and they had to go somewhere, so prices were high. We stayed at a hotel for a couple nights, and then we came back home and tried for another night or two, and it was just super cold. So we went to another hotel again, and then we went to a bed and breakfast for a couple nights. So it was quite the experience. Walking around, found this whole bottle in the ground. That's pretty cool. It's got like greenery, foliage growing inside of it. That's pretty cool.
Is it one of the actual? It's a newer one. You can tell by the seam in the glass. So it's one of the ones that made to look old, like vintage, but it's not that old because of the seam in the glass here.
What kind of bottle is it? Is it a Pepsi bottle? I don't know. Crush?
Crush.
I think it's a Crush bottle.
Yeah.
Looks cool, but it's not that old. Still looks cool though. I'm going to try to come around this way. Let's go down there and look. Take a closer look at this water. This slough here. So anyway, we're just coming back from recovering from not having power for 10 days. Went through a lot of candles, a lot of firewood, a lot of nights in other places too. But now we're getting back in the groove, getting things back together. We both worked through most of it. I was off for a couple days, so was Lady B, when things were really bad. Roads were super icy, couldn't drive.
And also we don't have internet still.
Everything but the kitchen sink, except here it is. There's the kitchen sink.
Oh, it is a sink. Wow.
It is. Yeah, we barely have cell phone service out here at all. Hardly any data, even on our phones. So things are so bad out here. What is this down in the water here? Little kid's tricycle type thing? Yeah, it is. Bunch of... These are like blackberry bushes, it looks like.
Yeah.
Wonder if there's any good fishing out here.
Came from the Mackenzie, so there may be some fish that wandered over here.
The tributary from the Mackenzie River, huh?
The last time I walked over here, I don't think there was any water in this, was there?
There was a little bit here, but just a little bit further down it was dried up. Okay. But I don't think there was this much, but I have noticed that waters are higher in general around town.
Yeah, whatever they have, the ice melted, right?
Yeah. There's this tree that's down, but if you look around here on the blackberry thistles, oh look, there's Brer Bear. It's like a little cave down in there. Can't really go in there because of the blackberry thistles, but it looks like a little cave. So we decided we'd come in here and do a little bit of a lakeside chat. Also, we're going to do a Patreon exclusive giveaway, some Disney merch here later on in the video. We'll skip to after we're done recording out here, go inside and do a video, a giveaway for our patrons. But for now, we're just walking around, just giving a little life update. It's been a crazy couple weeks with no power and kind of living out of home. All right, so as aforementioned, it is now later in the day. We've came in, had dinner, sit down, watched some Adam the Woo videos.
Yeah.
And now we're going to do our giveaway. I think we alluded to this a couple weeks ago when we went to Woodburn and went shopping. We have this cool Disney cup. It does say 2023 on the straw. It's because we got it at the warehouse, but it has a pendant that does come off. Yep. So if you do want to slide that off, it won't say it anymore. Inside, we have the names on paper of all of our patrons.
They're in
and
there.
This is a patron giveaway only.
Yep.
For as little as $1 a month, you could become a patron.
$1. Should we do it?
Yes. All of our patrons, thank you, all patrons, for all that you do. This is a special thank you to you.
Got that?
Got it.
Okay. That one.
Got a winner. We have a winner.
Hold that.
We have a winner.
Got a winner.
Here's our winner.
Gonna be backwards, but it's
Dave Gibson.
Dave Gibson.
Dave Gibson.
Yay, Dave.
Good job, Dave.
Nice.
Yes.
Wonderful.
And Sid.
Oh, and Sid. Sid, you can take this to school.
Yeah.
All the cool kids are taking Disney cups to school.
Yep. So there's that. Congratulations, Dave Gibson.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure I have your address. I know for sure I have your address.
Yep, we just sent
it. You sent it to me. Yep. In Kittery, right? Kittery,
Maine. Yep.
So we'll send this out to you.
We will.
Right away?
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yes.
Go check us out on Patreon. Patreon.com/incognito mouse. And stay tuned. Next week, we're going to Denver and Wyoming. And we'll do another patron exclusive video while we're there.
Yeah.
And we'll give a little bit more in-depth information about our eventual move to Florida.
Timeline.
We'll give you a little more about the timeline, what needs to happen, how far down the line we're looking. As of right now, we're just saying, not now, but sooner than later, but also later than sooner. So, stick around.
Yes.
Not a good camera angle with the sunlight behind us. I always like to do future video ideas, futures of the channel, upcoming life plans, things like that. People like to talk about that. People like to hear that. Right now, we're just out exploring getting out because we've been trapped in the house for so long. It's nice to just get out and look. And there are some paths back here. Oh, this is cool.
Not a private property.
Yeah. Looks like a logging road or something.
Yeah.
So this, in about a week, well, today's Monday. As of the recording of this video, it's Monday. On Friday, Lady B and I are going to be flying out to Denver International Airport, visiting some friends in Wyoming. Actually, the pastor who married us back in May. We're going to visit him because he and his wife are very good friends with us. Mm-hmm. And with Lady B for a long time, they've been good friends. So we're just going to go out and visit them for a couple days, and we'll probably do some videos out there flying to Denver and different fun things we're gonna do there in town with them. That'll be good. We're walking along. You see a path down there we were thinking about walking down, but it looks too treacherous to get over there. We're not quite sure if this is private property. Maybe some other time we'll drive down and see if that road says private. It says dead end. I see the road sign, Cedar something road. We'll see if it says private property. If not, we may walk down there some point. But anyway, I was looking over here and I saw this log in the water, and I was like, oh my goodness, that looks like a gator. Do you see it? Like it's looking right at us, the snout. Of course, I'm zoomed way in, but from here what we're seeing, which is like out here more, right there is regular. It looks like a gator. The snout. Wonderful. So the question that some of you guys may be wondering and has been indeed on our minds also is, Vicky, are you even going to move back to Florida? When are you moving back? Keep saying you are, then you don't, that you are still here in Oregon. So what is going on? I know. I talked about it before. You know, I was in Florida, living that Florida life. I had every intention of living there for the rest of my life, retiring, being a Disney driver, but life happened. Noisy truck drove by.
We live by a noisy highway
on our way out to the middle of nowhere. Life happened. I got divorced, and it was quite an ugly ordeal. Drawn out, dragged out, attorneys involved. Not good. So it was quite a major setback financially for me personally, which put us in a less than desirable position. So we're working our way back. We still have every plan and intention of being there. I hate to set a timeline because I feel like it locks us down. We have in our mind a time frame, not an exact date, but a time frame. But I'm not ready to put it out into the universe yet. Just to say, sometime in the near distant future, we will be moving to Florida. I'm not going to say within this many months or whatever. Sometime, not too far out not too far out in the, you know, decades away or whatever, but sometime relatively soon, if not later. So we do have plans. We are still on our trajectory, and I just got snagged up on a blackberry thistle. We are going, just not just yet. Hang in there with us. We're going to keep doing our adventures here in Oregon, enjoying ourselves, preparing, saving, looking for a place to live. And once we do make that announcement, we will chronicle it here, because that's one thing I wish I would have done on my last move to Florida. I wish I would have. One of the things I wish last time I moved to Florida, I wish I would have chronicled it, showed videos of the whole process. And this time, once we make the announcement and make it public, for reals this time, we're doing it. We have solid plans in place. We're going to chronicle it. We're going to show the process, the moving process, the packing process, finding a place, you know, how we did it. Do we rent a U-Haul? Do we purge everything? Do we get pods? I don't know yet. We're still working on that. But once we make that date public, which will be soon, our patrons will probably know a little bit sooner than everyone else, because that's just how we roll.
We should make a patron video and give them the timeline.
Yeah, so we'll do that. We'll make a Patreon video soon after this one releases and give them a more precise timeline. So if you don't know exactly when we're leaving, go check us out on Patreon. Mm-hmm. Patreon.com/incognitomouse for as little as $1 a month. $1 a month.
That's it.
And also subscribe and like.
Yes, tell them again.
Subscribe and like.
Make sure you like and subscribe our channel.
Yes.
Go check us out on Patreon if you want to know, if you want to help the channel along. And once we get back in the swing of things, I used to have different tiers on Patreon with different levels of rewards and everything like that. And it was really engaging, and we had a great community. Now that we've kind of moved away from Florida, and the vision of going there got kind of distant and clouded for a while. Mm-hmm. Patreon was just kind of there, but I wasn't doing much with it. And all the levels just kind of get the same rewards now, whether you give a dollar, or the highest level I have is $20. And I don't even have anybody on that level now. I did at one point, but yeah, it was Lady B. If you want to go check that out, you can. And we'll, that'll be a bleep for you. If you want to go check out Patreon, you're welcome to. You don't have to. I'm not asking anybody to go give money. If you want to, you can. Mm-hmm. But we will do a video for the patrons giving away a prize today. And then we'll also do another video telling them a little bit more better specific timeline. Mm-hmm. So we are moving at some point, sooner than later, but also later than sooner, if that makes any kind of sense.
Definitely, we're very much more motivated by this timeline this time.
And we're pinpointed, and we have goals and solid goals in place. So we will be moving back to Florida.
Yes.
Come check out Patreon if you find out where I'm working and what exactly I'm doing. Am I working at Disney? Am I not? I don't know. Well, I know, but you might not know. So come check us out. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for being part of our journey. And remember, wasio na hofu is Swahili for they who have no fear.
Hurry back.
And we also going to do a giveaway too.
Chronicled it and showed how we found somewhere to live, how we prepared, all that kind of stuff.
Blooper.
Lady B is trying to help me settle the camera and got in front of it with her finger in the front of the camera.
That's going to be a blooper.
Yeah.
Okay, start over.
So I showed a video earlier of this sink that we found. I actually grabbed it and yanked it out of the ground. You can see here, this hole here is where that sink used to be. It's a sinkhole!
And also,
but anyway,
comment a pizza.
What?
Comet a pizza.
Comet a pizza?
Yeah.
I don't know.